Welcome to SAT Prep Thursday. Today, we're going to be doing College Board SAT Practice Test Number 5, Part 4, Numbers 1 through 20. This is a calculator-approved section, so I will be using either a TI-30XS or a TI-30XA. Also, there's a file link in the description for this practice test. According to the line graph above, between which two consecutive years was there the greatest change in the number of 3D movies released? So we're talking about the greatest change, and I think it's fairly obvious at this point in the graph, meaning we're looking at from 2010 to 2011, so D is the answer. Some values of linear function f are shown in the table above. Which of the following defines f? So I think it's fairly obvious to look at this and say all of their slopes are quite different. So how about we look at slope being the change of y over change in x? This means I can look at 13 minus 5 over 3 minus 1, which would give us 8 over 2, which is a slope of 4. So C is the answer. To make a bakery's signature chocolate muffins, a baker needs 2.5 ounces of chocolate for each muffin. How many pounds of chocolate are needed to make 48 signature chocolate muffins? And 1 pound is equal to 16 ounces. Well, we're going to set up a very easy ratio here. We know that 2.5 over x, this is talking about ounces, unknown, so we have small over large. We know that we have 16 ounces over 1 pound. Just by solving this, we get to say that 2.5 divided by 16 would give us x, which is 0.15628. Now we have this number, but we have to multiply it because we have to figure out pounds. So we're going to multiply by, or we're going to multiply it by 48 because we need to figure out the number of muffins, not we've already got the pounds. This is going to give us 7.5. So A is the answer. If 3 times the sum of C and D is equal to 5, what is the value of C and D? Well, I feel like this is fairly obvious that C plus D would be equal to 5 divided by 3. So B is the answer. The weight of an object on Venus is approximately 9/10 of its weight on Earth. The weight of an object on Jupiter is 23/10 of its weight on Earth. If an object weighs 100 pounds on Earth, approximately how many more pounds does it weigh on Jupiter than on Venus? Well, we know that Venus is 9/10 of Earth. We also know that Jupiter is 23/10 of Earth. If an object weighed 100 pounds on Earth, 100 times 9 over 10 means on Venus it would weigh 90 pounds. And on Jupiter, we would get 230 pounds. So 230 minus 90 will give us 140. C is the answer. An online bookstore sells novels and magazines. Each novel sells for $4 and each magazine sells for $1. If Sadie purchased a total of 11 novels and magazines that have a combined selling price of $20, how many novels did she purchase? So we need to build a system of equations. We know that the total of what she bought, novels and magazines, was equal to 11. We know that it is $4 for a novel and $1 for a magazine. She spent $20. This is now my system of equations. Now I'm going to multiply this top one by a negative 1, changing all of the signs, meaning I get to have 3x, the y's eliminate, is equal to 9. So x is equal to 3. So now I can say the x plus y is equal to 11, meaning 3 plus y is equal to 11, or y is equal to 8. But 3 was what we needed. B, 3 is the answer. The Downtown Business Association, or DBA, in a certain city plans to increase its membership by a total of N business per year. There were B business in the DBA at the beginning of this year. Which function best models the total number of business Y the DBA plans to have as members X years from now? So we already know that we need a y equals. It's obvious for the answer, but it's what we're after as a result. Now, we want to increase by n business per year. This means we're talking about n times x. Now, if it doesn't have an n times x, then we can eliminate it as an option. We also know how many businesses there were already, and that was b, meaning we have a as the answer. Which of the following is an equivalent form of 1.5x minus 2.4 squared minus 2.5x squared minus 6.4. So what we want to do first is get rid of these parentheses. And one of the easiest ones to get rid of is this negative into the parentheses. So we can have a negative 5.2x squared, and I'm going to skip the space that has x, and a plus 6.4. Now we need to multiply this out, meaning 1.5x times 1.5x is a 2.25x squared. 1.5x times negative 2.4, but we're going to do this twice, so then times 2 would give us negative 7.2x. And then negative 2.4 times negative 2.4 would be plus 5.76. Now we can add both of these together. The negative 5.2x squared plus 2.25x squared is negative 2.95x squared. So if it doesn't start with a 2.95, I can go ahead and eliminate it. Now in this case, I'm looking at what is different. I don't care about that negative 7.2. It's in both of them. But am I dealing with a positive 12.16 or a 0.64? Well, 5 and 6 is 11 plus this amount, which means I'm dealing with a larger number than a zero, so C is the answer. In the 1908 Olympic Games, the Olympic marathon was lengthened from 40 kilometers to approximately 42 kilometers. Of the following, which is the closest to the increase in distance of the Olympic marathon in miles? And 1 mile is approximately 1.6 kilometers. So we're dealing with miles over kilometers. So we have 1 mile is 1.6 kilometers. And we want to know how many miles were increased when it increased 2 kilometers. This means I'm going to deal with 2 divided by 1.6, which is 1.25, or B is the answer. The density D of an object is found by dividing the mass M of the object by its volume. Which of the following equations gives the mass m in terms of d and v? So we have to start by writing the equation that the density of an object is found by. So we have d is equal to, and it is dividing the mass by the volume. So m divided by v. And we're solving for m. And so d times v would be equal to m, meaning a is the answer. In the xy plane, the graph of which of the following equations is perpendicular to the graph of the equation above? So let's turn this first equation into y is equal to mx plus b form. This means I have 3y is equal to 2x plus 6, or y is equal to 2 over 3x plus 2. Now, a perpendicular slope would be equal to the opposite inverse, meaning I'm looking for a slope of negative 3 over 2. So I need some equation that would be y is equal to negative 3 over 2x plus some number. If I move the x to the other side, I get 3 over 2x plus y is equal to a, which means that 3x plus 2y is equal to 2a. This is the part I'm paying the most attention to, 3x plus 2y. The only 3x plus 2y that I see is a, so a is the answer. The system of equations above has solution xy. What is the value of x? Let's add both of these equations together because I have a 1/2 x minus 1/2 x. This is going to give me x is equal to 4 plus 2, which is 6, so 6 is the answer. Which of the following ordered pairs xy satisfies the systems of inequalities above? So to do this, let's go ahead and graph both of these equations. In this case, if x was 0, then y would be at 1. It has a slope of 3, which means I get to go up 3 to the right 1 and get a second point. This gives me my first equation. But everything that's going on here must be less than or equal to this. Now, I can ask the question, is 0, 0 an answer? Is 0 less than or equal to 1? Yes, so I can shade beneath it. Now, to graph this second one, if x is 0, then y is less than negative 1. So I have a negative 1, and I know that I'm shading down. If y was 0, then x is greater than a positive 1. Now I have two lines. I have a shaded region for both. And it's only this whole shaded region that actually works as an answer. So negative 2, negative 1 is not in the double shaded region. A is out. Negative 1, 3 would be somewhere here, so it's out. 1, 5 would be up here, it's out, and 2, negative 1 would be about here, so D is the answer. In a survey, 607 general surgeons and orthopedic surgeons indicated their major professional activity. The results are summarized in the table above. If one of the surgeons is selected at random, which of the following is closest to the possibility or the probability that the selected surgeon is an orthopedic surgeon whose indicated professional activity is research? So what I need to know is orthopedics that do more research, and that is a 74. There's a total of 607. So I'm looking at 74 over 607, which is 0.122, and A is the answer. A polling agency recently surveyed 1,000 adults who were selected at random from a large city and asked each of the adults, "Are you satisfied with the quality of air in the city?" Of those surveyed, 78% responded that they were satisfied with the quality of air in the city. Based on the results of the survey, which of the following statements must be true? Of all of the adults in the city, 78% are satisfied with the air quality in the city. Now, it says all adults, and they only surveyed 1,000, so this is not true, meaning if it contains a 1, it can't be an answer. Now, I'm only interested in checking number 2. If another 1,000 adults selected at random from the city were surveyed, 78% of them would report they're satisfied with the air quality in the city. And the fact that it's a would, perhaps a number is much higher, perhaps it's much lower. So 2 is not true, meaning A is the answer. Questions 16 through 18 are going to refer to the following information. One method of calculating the approximate age in years of a tree of a particular species is to multiply the diameter of the tree in inches by the constant called the growth factor for that species. The table above gives the growth factor for 8 species of tree. According to the information in the table, what is the approximate age of an American elm tree with a diameter of 12 inches? Well, the American elm has a growth factor of 4. So if we multiplied that by the 12, we would get 48, giving us D is the answer. The scatter plot above gives the tree diameter plotted against the age of 26 trees of a single species. The growth factor for the species is closest to that of which of the following species of tree? So what we're going to do is we're looking at a line of best fit. And now we're going to choose one that's just slightly above, and we're going to choose one that is just slightly below. This lets us go ahead and find out the slope, that is change in y over change in x. So in this case, I can look at about 110 minus 80 over 15 minus 11, giving us a 30 over 4 or 7.5. This is the slope that we're looking for. The growth factor of a shagbark hickory is 7.5, which means that D is the answer. If a white birch tree and a pine oak tree each now have a diameter of 1 foot, which of the following will be the closest to the difference in inches of their diameter 10 years from now? And remember that 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. So the white birch at 12 times 5 is 60 years old. The pine oak, 12 times 3, would give us 36 years old. This is what's needed so that we can say in 10 years, how would it be? Looking at the white birch, then at 70, we're looking at 70 divided by 5 means it would be 14. The pine oak at now 46, 10 more than at 36 would be 46 over 3, which is 15.3. So we can see 15.3 minus 14 would give us 1.3 is the difference in size, so C is the answer. In triangle ABC above, what is the length of AD? We can start by filling in some information that we know about this triangle. This is 30, this angle is 30, this angle is 60. So if I look at this whole triangle, I also know that this side is 12. This means that this is an equilateral triangle, meaning AC must also be 12. But I only want to know about AD, which is half of 12 or 6. The figure on the left above shows a wheel with a mark on its rim. The wheel is rolling on the ground at a constant rate along a level straight path from a starting point to an ending point. The graph of y is equal to d of t on the right could represent which of the following as a function of time from when the wheel begins to roll. So I think the key here is in this graph, y is equal to d as a function of t, distance as a function of time. So if it doesn't talk about distance, we get to eliminate that as an answer. Now this is a wave showing how that mark moves up and down as it's rolling. So I think the distance of the wheel from the starting point would not be it, and the distance of the mark on the rim from the center of the wheel, but that would remain the same, so it's definitely out. Now the distance of the mark from the rim from the ground, I think that is a very good indication of what's going on with this graph, so D is the answer.